Hello, everyone. Welcome to this episode of the Connect series. Thanks for joining us. My name is Nick Smith. As you can see, Adrian's missing today, so things should run pretty smoothly. I'm here with William Goh. He's a systems expert on different wireless technologies. He's here to talk about a technology guide that he wrote to kind of help users select what the appropriate wireless technology is for their application. Thanks for joining, Will.
No, thank you. It's my pleasure.
Yeah, so maybe to get us started, can you talk a little bit about why you wrote this? What was the motivation behind it?
Sure. No. So one of the big key motivation for writing this paper is to really help and guide new customers that's coming into the wireless world of technology. Wireless technology can be very complex, complicated. There's a lot of new standards that really come out on a year-to-year basis. You know, you can think of wireless technologies like Zigbee, Bluetooth, Thread, and many, many more out there that customers may not know what's the pros and what's the cons behind which wireless technology do I need to get started for their application. So the whole sole purpose of this paper is to help them guide through these different certain criteria that they need to care about to pick their right wireless technology there.
Okay, so I mean, essentially the world of connectivity, as we all know, is complicated. So what you're doing is giving them kind of a get started here. These are the things to think about. Can you talk a little bit about, maybe before you even dive into the individual technologies, what are some of the factors that we should think about when we're making our selection?
Yeah, so absolutely. So one of the key factors that you'll see in this paper and the structure of it is customers. So think about what are your first thing is, what is your application use case that you're trying to do? And then kind of drill down into understanding what kind of network topology do you need? Do you need it to be peer-to-peer communication? Do you need to be more like a star network communication? Or do I need to do a mesh network communication across different nodes there? And then think of also about, is this application going to be low power? Is it ultra low power? Or is it going to be line power? Or is it going to be battery powered? So energy consumption comes into play for selecting the right wireless technology. Also, data bandwidth is the other aspect here. Think about, am I going to be pushing small amount of data, large amount of data? And this also determines that factor there. And last but not least is also the range itself. So depending on how far do you need to communicate, is it going to be several meters? Or is it going to be me and you here like that? Or is it going to be ultra long? It's going to be thousands of meters away. So, and this is going to help you guide through what is the right wireless technology to. It's also what the right frequency band that you will need to be running in based on your selection criteria there.
Okay. So yeah, you kind of start with what's your application, and then your guide will walk them through, you know, here's how to think about selecting based on what network topology you need, what power consumption level you need, what kind of data bandwidth you need, and you had a fourth one.
It's range itself.
Range you need. So you'll walk through all four of those and kind of help make the selection. Can you give us maybe an example of the, I don't want you to spoil your whole guide here, but just maybe an example of this analysis for an end equipment.
So think about if you're a customer trying to develop a heart rate monitor application for you. So a heart rate monitor is something that you wear on your wrist and you monitor your heart rate periodically throughout the day. Ideally, you want your heart rate monitor to last at least the whole entire day or maybe multiple days that you want to wear on a single charge, right? So it needs to be low power or semi-ultra low power, their wireless communication. It needs to periodically measure and send the data. And usually when you send the data, you have your smartphone. Everyone has a smartphone, and a smartphone is, what's the easiest way to connect to a smartphone is typically through a Bluetooth low energy communication. And you know, maybe think about using that as an example, as a starting point, where Bluetooth is typically a design for short range communication, ultra low power design, and also it's able to do any kind of data communication in a much quick fashion for you to get started there.
Okay, yeah, so because you have something wearable on your arm, low power, close range communication, and connection to a smartphone, you might pick Bluetooth low energy and get started there. Where on the other hand, you wouldn't pick, you know, say sub 1 gigahertz that it can achieve very long range and low data throughput. Can you walk us through an example of maybe where you'd select something like sub 1 gigahertz?
Sure. So think about sub 1 gigahertz is where you really want to start doing long range communication there, as you were mentioning. So a sub 1 gigahertz does not just the long range itself, but you also won't be able to push as much data as you can while you're trying to do with the Bluetooth technology itself, just because of the amount of bandwidth in the sub 1 gigahertz spectrum. So in, for example, a perfect application where sub-1 gigahertz come into play is, for example, grid. So like if you have meters in your house, typically most of these meters will communicate in a sub-1 gigahertz spectrum. They will communicate their data back to the base station, and also the base station is able to communicate with the meters, telling it, hey, what does it need to do next? If it needs to cut the power down, or it needs to disconnect the power, or it needs to know how much power is consumed, everything through wireless remote control there. So sub-1 gigahertz extend the range, and also there are certain protocols within the sub-1 gigahertz that allows you to do mesh networking so you can communicate. So you can really extend your whole entire network and the whole entire community there without requiring additional base stations in every single sub-neighborhoods in itself there.
Okay. Yeah, makes sense. And, you know, this is just the tip of the iceberg of what your guide will cover. It'll kind of help people make those decisions on their own once they define what their application is going to be. Now, we'll definitely put a link to the guide below and make sure people can find that. Where else can they get started for some of these connectivity resources?
Sure. So one other thing is, once you finish through reading this technology guide here, the next step for the customer is it will help you to go to the next step, which is where read more about the wireless technology. So this is widely available on TI.com and within the SimpleLink portal page, where we talk about every single wireless technology in depth. On top of that, there's also the Connect series video for each and every individual wireless technology that we support also. So that's also another great resource for the customers to go off and really learn more about it. And then on top of that, after that, this is where you start going and, you know, purchasing a launch pad and start working with the device itself. And on top of that, we have a full-blown SDK that the customer can go and download, including the full wireless stack support that's also available for the customer, and start developing from there.
Great. Yeah, so they can kind of start at the beginning, define their system, learn about which connectivity solution is correct, and then you know, the TI resources can take them all the way into creating their end product.
That's exactly right.
Awesome. Well, yeah, I really appreciate you being here, William. It's great. The world of wireless connectivity is complicated, so it's always nice to have an expert kind of walk us through everything. So, and thank you guys. Thanks for joining this episode of Connect. Be sure to check out the technology guide that William's written. It's very extensive, a lot of good information in there. As always, you can tweet at us at @sensortocloud if there's any topics you'd like us to cover. And don't forget to tune in next week. We have another great episode coming. Thanks, everybody.
Thank you.